the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you, with your spirit. We once again unite ourselves in the spirit of prayer with Jesus with us in this Eucharistic celebration as we celebrate the memorial of Saints Cornelius and Cyprian. So, my dear friends, let us now prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, asking the Lord for pardon and strength. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who gave Saints Cornelius and Cyprian to your people as diligent shepherds and valiant martyrs, grant that through their intercession we may be strengthened in faith and constancy, and spend ourselves without reserve for the unity of the Church. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I am going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. But if there are gifts of prophecy, the time will come when they must fail, or the gift of languages. It will not continue forever, and knowledge, for this too, the time will come when it must fail. For our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophesying is imperfect. But once perfection comes, all imperfect things will disappear. When I was a child, I used to talk like a child, and think like a child, and argue like a child. But now I am a man. All childish ways are put behind me. Now we are seeing a dim reflection in a mirror. But then we shall be seeing face to face. The knowledge that I have now is imperfect, but then I shall know as fully as I am known. In short, there are three things that last: faith, hope, and love. The greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Happy the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. Happy the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. Give thanks to the Lord upon the harp. With a 10-stringed lute, sing him songs. Oh, sing him a new song that is new. Play loudly with all your skill. Happy the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. For the word of the Lord is faithful, and all his works to be trusted. The Lord loves justice and right, and fills the earth with his love. Happy the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. They are happy whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen as his own. May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hope in you. Happy the people the Lord has chosen to be his home. Alleluia, alleluia. Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia. The Lord be with you, with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to the people, "What description can I find for the men of this generation? What are they like? They are like children shouting to one another while they sit in the marketplace. We played the pipes for you, and you wouldn't dance. We sang dirges, and you wouldn't cry. But John the Baptist comes, not eating bread, nor not drinking wine, and you say, he is possessed. The Son of Man comes, eating and drinking, and you say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom has been proved right by all her children." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We are to reflect the first reading we've heard today from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, especially. It's a good encouragement and invitation for us to reach the highest goal. And this goal, of course, what he means is to be united with God. But on reaching that goal, he emphasized love. Of course, in the last sentence, he emphasized there are three things that last: faith, hope, and love. The greatest of these is love, because love is the very foundation and expression, a real expression of the faith and of the hope. Especially as Christians, we know and believe that the foundation of our relationship with God and God's ultimate revelation in Jesus Christ is love. Ultimately, that love which we are commanded to do in our life by Jesus is a love that goes beyond our human understanding, a love which we all are capable of doing. And rediscovering that love in Jesus, perhaps, as I always say, the crucifix is a point of reflection. The image of the crucifix, it's a good point of reflection for us to really know and understand what love really means by God. So much so that this is the same love that we exist, and the same love that we try to express in our life. Let us once again be strengthened by that same love which God has shown us in Jesus, because it is the same love that we ought to live as Christians. My dear friends, let us now offer all our prayers and petitions to our loving God, that the church on earth may continue to thrive and draw more faithful to the peace of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That the rich and the poor alike may not make excuses to evade the call of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That we may respond to the call for repentance with sincerity. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. that all of us may be committed to the cause of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That those who have died may live in the house of the Lord and rejoice in the banquet of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we offer you these prayers of ours. Hear and answer them through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offerings of your people in honor of the passion of your holy martyrs, Saints Cornelius and Cyprian, and may the gifts that gave them courage under persecution make us too steadfast in all trials, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith, to their endurance you grant firm resolve, and in their struggle the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we with all the hosts of angels cry out, and without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Peter, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us now pray with confidence to the Father and the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, I said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. I invite you now to take this moment to pray the act of spiritual communion, also from some moments of private prayer. Let us pray. Through these mysteries which we have received, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that by the example of the martyrs, Saints Cornelius and Cyprian, we may be strengthened with the fortitude of your Spirit to bear witness to the truth of the gospel, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you once again for joining and participating with me in this Eucharistic celebration. Join me once again tomorrow at 10 a.m. for the live streaming of our Mass, as we continue to be strengthened by the grace of God's love and also through prayer as we continue in this journey. Let us not lose hope, because God's hope is real, strengthening us and leading us to the light of life, and our love for God and for one another is strengthened. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.